Hi everyone, Sam Jackson here, currently in Da Nang, Vietnam, and doing a bit of travel trading. So today I'm going to show you how to create a stochastics trading strategy using EA Studio and go through a bit of a example workflow on how I do things. So I'll move to the computer and show you how that's done. So you can see here, I have running a generator now for nearly an hour and it's collected nearly 230 strategies. So just before I stop that, I'll just show what I've done. So I've got the data sources set to Darwin X, USD JPY, I've chosen M30. I've chosen 10 years of data. So just from the latest date, and I've just gone 10 years back. I've got a fixed stop loss and take profit in those ranges from 20 to 200. I'm generating on 70% in sample, so this white part here. And I'm allowing 4 entry indicators, 2 exits, and I've got working minutes, but I've only let it run for an hour. I usually have this set very high, or if you set it to 0, it'll just run indefinitely. And so it's using the common acceptance criteria, which is quite a straightforward acceptance criteria of in sample 100 trades and minimum profit factor of 1.2. So we'll look to kind of use the EA Studio's filtering ability in the collection and use the performance filters as we go through the workflow to target the more desirable statistics. But for now, just to get a bunch in the collection, that's quite a good way to do it. And in terms of targeting the stochastic strategy, so I've turned off pretty much everything and it's only generating based on the RSI indicator and the stochastic indicator. Both are pretty similar indicators indicating overbought and oversold values. So I'll stop that generator, and the first thing I'll do after that is, we can see there's lots of reasonable abstraction. The first thing we'll do, I had a peek at one, which is why that's turned up white. So if I download that collection and save our work, that's good. Okay, so now that collection's saved. So we obviously haven't, we can see there's a few robustness tests I want to do here. So I want to, one, I want to make sure that I'm happy with its out of sample performance. So we can see here, this is great out of sample performance, as is this. As we go further on, there'll be some that maybe aren't so good. So that one's performed well in sample, but not so good out of sample. And so I want to filter out the ones that don't perform well out of sample. I also want to perform a couple of robustness tests. One is that I'd like it to, we've used the Darwin X data, so I'd like to see how it goes on one of the other data sources. I'll use Black Bull. And then also, I would maybe like to see how it performs as a multi-market on a few other JPY pairs. So that's kind of three tests I'm going to run it through. And then at the end, of course, depending how many we've got, after that kind of filter process, we will use the performance filters to kind of pick the strategy we like the look of best, and we will then trade that on a demo account. If it performs well on the demo account, then we'll move it to live. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to run the out of sample one first. That to me is actually one of the most important robustness tests. I'd like to see how it performs out of sample. So I'm going to go to the validator. I'm going to delete this, and in the validator, I'm going to upload that collection. We're going to use the 30% again, but this time we are going to see, so we know that we've got this already. Let's minimum profit factor 1.2 and 1.1 is fair. So let's see how many are actually performing well out of sample. Okay, so as you get, EA Studio obviously calculates very, very quickly, so we're almost there. And we seem to be getting about 30% of them are performing well out of sample. So let's just have a quick scan through those at this point. And we can maybe just quickly manually eliminate any we're not so liking the look of. I'm not gonna be too, yeah, all good. We'll leave them just now. We'll download that collection. They're all looking reasonable. So that one passed the first. We can be a bit more scrutinous as we go through the flow and we have less in the collection. So let's now import that, and we will test it on a different data source. And I kind of expect this to get rid of quite a few of them. So minimum count of trades, let's again go 100, like that to be the same. Let's do the minimum profit factor, 1.1 here and 1.0. I'm going to be trading it on Darwin X, but let's just make sure that it performs at least reasonably well on Black Bull. Okay, so now we've got 14 that are also performing reasonably well on Black Bull. And as we can see, we Yeah. No, don't like that. I don't like that big drop. Okay, so we will download this collection. And now we'll go back to working with Darwin X data, but now we've only got 12. And so we'll run the final multi-market validation. And so I'd like, let's see very quickly how many just passed two. And so, I better just go and check. I'm pretty sure. So I just want it to be profitable on another market. So let's run that. Sorry, I'm in Vietnam and the internet can be a little bit slow. So if it jams, that'll be the cause. So we've got eight. I'm happy with eight, so let's download that final collection. Okay, so at this point we've got strategies that have, they've gone through 8 cap, but that's okay. It's still a valid robustness test. So we've got 8 strategies that have gone through several robustness tests at this point. So I'm gonna delete that and I will import that back in. I will change the data source. It automatically picks up what it was used. So it was used 8 cap when the collection was exported, and so it automatically knows that these are 8 cap. But we're gonna change that to Darwin X, and we will just, we can run that multi-market. Yeah, probably, you know, quite a few more actually. Okay, we've got 5, that's good. So there are our final 5. And so at this point, we can kind of look at these a bit more scrutinously. So certainly this one at the top looks like a great strategy. This one here also looks very good. This one here has had a pretty big drawdown and recovered, maybe not so happy with that one. So really, I would say, I don't like the look of this one. I don't like the look of this one. I don't like the look of this one. So in this case, there is no real need, as I had intended, to use the performance fillers because it was pretty easy to see what the best ones were just visually, and there weren't that many to work with. However, if there had been, let's say, 20 got through or something like that, we could then use these performance filters and say, only show me the ones with, let's say, R squared of greater than 70, or, well, there we go, 85. So only one of ours passed the criteria. So this is 1 out of 2. I think the other one had like 60 or something. So we can kind of use some filters to kind of target, you know, a few of the good ones. But in this case, we've got 2 strategies that look very worth. They've passed a series of robustness tests and they look definitely worth putting on to demo account to trade. In terms of the strategy, again, I like the look of this, quite simple. And let's have a look at the other one. Again, 3-in-1 is quite a simple strategy. I tend to prefer less rules, but it's not critical. And so yeah, I'm gonna download both of these. I'll download them as an MT4, so I'll be trading on MT4. I'll download them as MT5 too, actually, because I will make these available, and I'll also download that final collection. So I'm gonna put these on my demo account, incubator account, and let these trade and track them and monitor them. And if they perform well, I will trade them live. So I'm going to make these expert advisors available for download. So if you want to download these and trade them yourself, you can do so by clicking the link in the description. And if you like this video, please click the like button and keep an eye out for future content. And if it's available, I'm going to show how we can use the walk forward analysis to perhaps see if these benefit from walk forward optimization. So if you're interested in that and that video is available, please click the link. Cheers.